So a lot of people are confused lately about home theater audio. So today I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about home theater audio. So stay tuned. So as TVs have gotten thinner and thinner, their sound has actually gotten worse over the years. So this has led people to go out and buy a soundbar or home theater receiver for better sound. Now most people are generally happy with their new speakers, but there are several ways that you can connect them. So if you're not using the best connection method, then you might be missing out on better sound. So today I want to go over all your different options and show you the best way to connect everything. Now I'm going to try to make this video as short as I can, but there is a lot of information to cram into this video. Some that you might not even be aware of, so do try to stay to the end if you can. So first I want to start with surround sound formats and configurations. Now there are a ton of different ways that you can set up surround sound speakers, but I'm going to go over just a few to give you an idea. So a surround sound format is basically what tells your soundbar or your home theater receiver exactly which sounds to send to certain speakers. So there are two major companies that specialize in surround sound formats. The first one is Dolby and the other is DTS. So on most Blu-rays, you're usually going to see one of four different formats. If it's Dolby, then it'll be either Dolby Atmos or Dolby True HD. If it's DTS, then you'll see DTS HD or DTS X. So when you go out to the store to purchase a home theater receiver, you'll see numbers like 5.2, 7.2, 9.2, and so on. And these numbers basically refer to the number of speakers that the receiver supports. So the first number tells you how many full range speakers it supports, and the second number tells you how many subwoofer speakers it supports. So a basic home theater surround sound setup is going to be considered 5.1, and this is going to include a center channel, two main speakers, two surround speakers, and a subwoofer. So since you have five full range speakers and one subwoofer, it's known as 5.1. So when you see things like 7.2, 9.2, or higher, they're basically expanding that 5.2 to more speakers. So these additional speakers can be used for a ton of different things. You can have height channels, wide channels, or even ceiling speakers. So for example, with Dolby Atmos and DTS:X, those formats actually use overhead speakers. So you can have two or more overhead speakers in that setup, and that's gonna give you way more immersive sound for things like raindrops and overhead helicopters flying and stuff like that. And they also make Dolby Atmos enabled speakers. Now these are basically gonna use top mounted speakers that are gonna reflect off the ceiling and bounce back towards the listening position, and that's gonna make it sound like you have ceiling speakers. Now it's not gonna sound as good as actual in-ceiling speakers, but it does work pretty well in some rooms. Now, if you want Dolby Atmos and you don't want to do a full home theater setup, they do have Dolby Atmos soundbars, and these work by also reflecting sound off the ceiling to make it sound like the sound is coming directly from the ceiling. So now that you understand the formats, let's go over the different types of connections. So analog stereo cables are the most common type of connection you'll find for connecting audio devices. This is going to include things like RCA cables or 3.5 millimeter cables and a ton of other different types of connections. Now these cables work just fine for connecting things like a phone, a CD player, or a Bluetooth adapter. However, they don't actually provide the best audio quality, especially for a home theater setup, since they only support two-channel audio. Now, one way you can get true surround sound from stereo cables is using what's called a multi-channel connection. And some devices like computers and Blu-ray players actually do have multi-channel outputs on them, and some audio receivers have multi-channel inputs. So these devices are going to have separate inputs for like subwoofer, center channels, surround speakers, and your main speakers, and they're all separated, so you actually do get true surround sound. So a step up from stereo cables is a digital connection using coax, which is basically just a simple RCA cable, or it can use a fiber optic cable known as Toslink. Now Toslink is a better alternative to coax since it's going to be immune to most interference since it's using fiber optics to send the signal. So unlike a stereo connection, an optical connection can actually send true DTS or Dolby surround form directly to your receiver or your soundbar. However, they don't support the newer audio formats like Dolby True HD, Dolby Atmos, or DTS:X, since those require an HDMI cable. So this brings us to HDMI, which is one of the most complex topics when it comes to home audio. And unlike an optical connection, an HDMI cable actually supports all of the latest surround sound formats. So this has forced home audio manufacturers to put HDMI ports on receivers and even some soundbars, but it has caused some issues because of HDCP. So I just recently did a video explaining HDCP and HDMI versions, so go ahead and check that video out if you haven't already, because it has a lot of useful information in it. But what this means is if you have a 4K Blu-ray player player connected to your soundbar or your home theater receiver, you may not be able to send 4K video if it doesn't support the right version, and you'd be forced to upgrade it in order to get 4K video to your TV. And this is because some 4K content is actually protected using HDCP 2.2, and if any of the devices that you're connecting it to doesn't support that version of HDCP, you're either going to get no video or you'll be limited to 1080p. So for example, let's say you have your 4K TV connected to your soundbar through HDMI, and you also have a 4K Blu-ray player connected to the soundbar as well. Now, even though your 4K Blu-ray player and your TV probably support HDCP 2.2, your soundbar might not support it. And in this case, you'll either get no video at all, or you'll be limited to 1080p video and it won't be in 4K. And the same is true for a home theater receiver. If it doesn't support the right version of HDCP, you're not gonna get 4K video. Now, there are a couple of ways around this situation. The first way is to just use an optical connection. So if you don't care about transmitting to new surround sound formats like Atmos or any of those, you can simply use an optical connection between your TV and your soundbar or your home theater receiver, and it will send the sound just fine, and that won't affect your 4K video at all. And another alternative is to use what's called ARC, or audio return channel. So ARC allows you not only to use an HDMI cable to send audio and video to your TV, but it also allows your TV to send audio back through the cable to your soundbar or your receiver. So this means you wouldn't have to use an optical cable in order to get audio from your TV's built-in apps back to your soundbar or your receiver. Another cool thing is that it'll also pass the audio from the devices that are connected to your TV back to your soundbar as well. So in order for this to work, you can use any HDMI cable. You just need to make sure that both your TV and your soundbar or receiver support ARC. Now, I know ARC seems really awesome, but there are some drawbacks to it. One issue is that even though it's using HDMI, most TVs don't actually send surround formats through ARC, so you're going to be limited to two-channel audio, which definitely sucks. And even the TVs that do send DTS aren't able to send the newer formats like Atmos or DTS HD. So in my opinion, this actually defeats the purpose of it in most cases. So if you have an older audio receiver and you want to be able to get the latest formats like Dolby Atmos, then you have two options. The first thing you can do is get an HDCP 2.2 HDMI splitter, and this is going to allow you to use one HDMI cable to send 4K video to your TV and use the other cable to send audio to your receiver. The other option is to simply use devices that have two HDMI outputs. So some Blu-ray players have more than one output for this specific reason. It's going to allow you to use one port for your TV and use the other port for your receiver. So in both of these situations, you wouldn't be affected by HDCP and you'd be able to take full advantage of 4K HDR in Dolby Atmos. All right, guys, I know that was a lot of information. Hopefully I covered any questions you may have had. If I missed anything, go ahead and post in the comment section and I'll respond to your questions and comments. Now, I have had several people ask me how they can support the channel, so I've actually started a Patreon page. So if you're interested, you can use the link in the video description to make a pledge, and that goes towards helping me make more reviews and tutorials. So I do appreciate your support, and I'll see you guys in the next video.